Welcome back to Combat Tech. Today, we're going to dive deep into the story of the U.S. Navy's next-generation surface combatant, the DDG-51 Flight 3 Arleigh Burke-class destroyer. Stay tuned to see how this warship will redefine naval warfare and discover one astonishing innovation even the saltiest sailors didn't see coming. Imagine you're out on the high seas, the horizon stretching endlessly, and you catch a glimpse of a silhouette, sleek, formidable, bristling with radar arrays. That's the Arleigh Burke-class destroyer. For over three decades, these warships have been the shield and sword of carrier strike groups, evolving through new flights to stay ahead of rising threats. And now, with Flight 3, we're witnessing the most dramatic leap in capability yet. If you've ever wondered how navies keep reinventing themselves to deal with faster, smarter, and deadlier threats, well, buckle up, because Flight 3 isn't just an upgrade, it's a revolution. Before we push forward, if you're enjoying this journey into cutting-edge military tech, hit that like button and subscribe for more deep dives into advanced defense systems. Let us know in the comments, what new technology do you think will change warfare? We'll keep an eye out for your insights. To truly appreciate the significance of Flight 3, we have to look at its proud heritage. When the first of these warships, USS Arleigh Burke DDG-51, was commissioned back in 1991, it introduced a new era of surface combat. Over time, the Navy introduced updated designs, or flights, layering in fresh technology and refined concepts. Today, Flight 3 is the pinnacle of that continuous evolution. Did you know? The USS Arleigh Burke was named after Admiral Arleigh Albert, 31 Knot Burke, famed for his speed and aggression in World War II. Yes, 31 Knot Burke was his nickname. A little slice of naval trivia to impress your friends at your next military history trivia night. Now let's talk tech. The heart of Flight 3 is its brand new air and missile defense radar, officially the AN-SPY-6. This system is so advanced, it can detect and track more incoming threats at once than any previous generation. Pair that with the Aegis Combat System, Baseline 10, and you have a warship ready to intercept ballistic missiles, advanced cruise missiles, and much more. But that's not all. Flight 3 features a suite of sensors and weapons that sound straight out of science fiction, like the ANSPQ-9B for low altitude detection, ANSQQ-89 Undersea Warfare Suite to track stealthy submarines, cooperative engagement capability that merges data from ships, aircraft, and shore installations, CWIP Block 2 for advanced electronic warfare, CWIS, close-in weapon system, Block 1B for last-ditch protection. It's serious business, but we gotta keep things lively, right? Here's a twist you might not expect. To fit all this cutting-edge gear, the ship's fantail was actually widened, and the Navy stacked 2 7-meter boats on top of each other to conserve space, like an epic maritime game of Tetris. But the most astonishing invention, one that even had seasoned sailors raising an eyebrow, comes later in this story. Trust me, it's worth the wait. Leading the Flight 3 charge is the USS Jack H. Lucas, DDG-125. Delivered to the Navy in June 2023 and commissioned that October. Consider it the Navy's newest crown jewel for integrated air and missile defense. And there are plenty more on the way, 11 currently under construction, 13 more on contract. This class will be the linchpin of the fleet for decades to come. By March 2024, this new powerhouse faced its trial by fire. Flight test Aegis Weapons System 32, FTM 32. The mission, detect, track, and simulate an intercept of a medium-range ballistic missile. Under the watchful eye of the Missile Defense Agency and the Navy's testing offices, the goal was simple. Prove the might of SPY-6 and Aegis Baseline 10. But technology rarely cooperates on the first try. FTM 32 offered significant intended data collection, yet glitches in the Aegis combat system and the AN-SPY-6 radar meant some vital data went unrecorded. In other words, it was a partial success and a partial mystery. The Navy isn't deterred. Further live trials and integrated tests for DDG-126, 128, and beyond are already in the pipeline. They're debugging software, refining hardware, and rallying the full might of the MDA and OPTV-4 to ensure the ship eventually hits every benchmark. Even champions stumble before they master the ring. Having fun learning about the real-world challenges behind these high-tech marvels? Don't forget to subscribe for more behind-the-scenes revelations and share this video to spread the word about the Navy's biggest leaps in modern warfare. A destroyer at sea faces more than ballistic missiles, high-speed cruise missiles, drone swarms, lurking subs, the list goes on. To prepare, the Navy needs test targets that accurately mimic new threats. But some advanced anti-ship missiles fly at hypersonic speeds or move in ways that current test drones can't replicate. Fun fact, some modern anti-ship missiles can approach speeds well over Mach 5. That's faster than your average sports car, times 1,000. If you can't test it, you can't fight it. That's why modeling and simulation steps in to fill the gap. But the real-world tests still matter, and the Navy's pushing for more realistic target drones to make sure they're 100% ready. But what about actual hits? Flight 3 must also prove it can take a punch. In October 2023, the Navy started blast fragility tests at Aberdeen Proving Ground, seeing how shipboard components hold up to explosive charges. Next up, testing the resiliency of doors and hatches through FY25. After all, if a single hatch fails in combat, you could lose an entire compartment to fire or flooding. The real nail-biter is the full ship shock trial. In FY26, two shots of high explosives detonated near the hull to confirm it can withstand the pressure. Imagine standing on deck as everything rattles. And I mean everything. It's the ultimate litmus test of design integrity. Remember that innovation even the saltiest sailors didn't see coming? Here it is. The cooperative engagement capability can network seamlessly with future unmanned platforms, like drone ships and aerial drones, creating a web of data so integrated, it's almost like telepathy between warships. Imagine an entire task force acting with one brain, firing interceptors and coordinating strikes without the delays of traditional comms. That's the potential of the Flight 3's brains and sensors, combined with next-gen unmanned vehicles. It's a force multiplier like never before. By early 2025, USS Jack H. Lucas and the rest of the Flight 3 fleet are knee-deep in software updates, data crunching, and final tweaks. The Navy aims to complete all tests, operational, live fire, shock, by fiscal year 2028. At that point, Flight 3 will officially be declared combat ready to take on any threat: ballistic missiles, stealth aircraft, enemy ships, and advanced submarines. This journey is more than just another destroyer class. It's a statement of American maritime commitment. Whether safeguarding carrier strike groups or patrolling contested waters, the DDG-51 Flight 3 stands as both protector and deterrent, capable of projecting power far beyond the horizon. So there you have it, the saga of the DDG-51 Flight 3, an enduring testament to American innovation. From the first conceptual designs to the high-stakes shock trials yet to come, this ship embodies a relentless pursuit of excellence. It's no simple process. There have been setbacks, partial successes, and constant refinements, but that's how greatness is forged. The next chapters will reveal the true measure of Flight 3 as testing continues, new ships join the fleet, and real-world deployments begin. But one thing's certain, the next time you spot a warship on the horizon, remember the stories behind its steel, the thousands of hours of research, design, testing, and training that make it not just a vessel, but a shield for our nation and allies. Thank you for sailing with us. If you found this video enlightening, be sure to like, subscribe, and drop a comment about what you think the future of naval warfare holds. Until next time, fair winds and following seas.